welcome to Beer Cockles Reviews McLager Monday. Why have I said it like it? McLager Mondays are back again. I'm trying to keep it upbeat. Whee! Right, so I'm going to be upbeat. You can see just it's just in the bottom of the screen. We've got a big tall one. You know, when I see these big tall ones, I'm like, oh, have I got to drink that much? This is a 640 ml, which is another strange number. 640 ml is 4.8 ABV. It's Tiger Brewery. I don't know whether you could describe it as Tiger Brewery. Tiger Brewery may be under the influence of, what's it called? Under the umbrella of Heineken UK. It's brewed under license from Asia Pacific Breweries Limited. And this is brewed Singapore. And it's by Heineken UK. I don't know whether it's brewed in UK or brewed in Singapore. It doesn't say. It says on the front here that it's been awarded championship gold medals in London, Geneva, Paris. Woo! Brewed and bottled by Heineken UK Limited. 2-4 Broadway Park, Edinburgh. And then it's got all their gump and everything else. There you go. Well, you go over it. There we go. Dum 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 dum. Dum 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 dum. All these bullshit, whatever. The awards and what have you. So if you can see them, there you go, you're getting it. Can't get in any closer because I'm right on top of the thing. But they're very small. Upbeat, come on. I'm like, do you know what? I'm determined to get to the end of these McLagers. But I've had enough, I really have. I've so had enough. I tell you what, the good thing about it is that every week it just reminds me of what you guys could be missing out on and that. You know, I don't mean that in a patronising way. I mean it kind of the reason I'm doing this on YouTube and that, the reason that I'm so passionate about it is because when you've tasted... I've tasted so much of the McLagers in my young days many years ago, and since then I've kind of gone looking for this. I think from day one, from drinking almost, I had lagers and was like, don't like this, put a top in it, like lemonade top, put a lime in it, lager and lime, put something in it, put snake bites, God knows what else. Lager and blackcurrant and anything to add to the taste. Then I went on to the what I called the brown drinks, you know, which is bitter, mild, anything else. Then I went to Guinness. Guinness I still go back to in the pub now and again if it's a widescreen boyo pub and that, you know, that don't sell anything better. I'll go to the draft Guinness and it's always, you know, guaranteed I'll enjoy it, you know. And it's very rare that you go in a pub, they ain't got Guinness or, something Murphy's or something else in there. So at least you've got something to fall back on. But where was I going with this? But the thing that drives me on with this, in doing these McLagers, and I am fed up with them, I really am. But the thing that drives me on with them is that if I've got these McLagers on there and people Google search it or something like this, pour this crap out first. People Google search it and everything. It's very pretty little crown. I like that. I collect crowns, by the way. I know it sounds a bit anal and everything, but I collect them. And if anyone knows the proper term for someone that collects crowns or caps, let me know. I know the ones that collect the things, the labiophiles. You've got what's the other one? God, blimey, look at that. That's smelling the neck. I don't know. It's actually smelling. God, it's smelling a bit farty as well, dear. And it's not skunk, that's something farty. I wonder if someone's been ramming that up their jacksie or something. With a crown on it. Ah! It's gone now, but yeah, it drives me on, and it also kind of, it reaffirms my belief in good beer. That when you taste this kind of generic, same old crap, because you could line a shitload of these up, you could line a table full up, and then say, find your one. I think the only one that I found that I went, that's a bit different, was the Bex one that I did. And that was kind of okay, passable, but still a street away from a proper beer. But anyway, I'll show you the colours here. Let's just get the white. That's about the white there, and that's the colour. Lovely little goldy colour and that light gold piss colour. Smells of wet cardboard, smells of fizzy water, cheap fizzy water and wet cardboard. A tiny bit of like a grainy edge to it. Like beer poured over cornflakes, sort of something like that as well. Right, you ain't getting nothing on that, so let's drink some. Right, that goes down smooth. That goes down smooth. Let's see what the carbonation's like. Not too bad. Yeah, it goes down smooth. That said, there's very little flavour going on. It's uninspiring. Listen, I don't mean to sound down, but if you are a McLager drinker and you've stuck with me for 8 minutes and whatever, before sort of typing out pee off or something like that, and then just switching off or whatever, if you've stuck with me this long, all I can say is kind of. Oh, I've just got a bit of aftertaste of that as well. That waited for ages to attack me. All I can say is that there is so much better stuff out there. I suggest that wait until, you know, you're giving yourself a treat. Christmas, a holiday, something like that. One of them little, like, I'm going to give myself a treat sort of things, and then go for, I don't know, Sierra Nevada or something like that, you know, go for something else, you know, go for something better. Kind of, maybe ask us guys, say, like, you know, is there anything that's not a big culture shock if you're used to McLagers? You know, obviously, oh dear, it's no good going straight into What's that? Just flew around the back of my head. It's no good going straight into a, you know, like a Guinness Foreign Extra or something like that, or, you know, something really, really strong. Because it's going to be too much. But this is horrible, you know. It's smooth to swallow, is what it is. So you got 4.8, you got... Do you know what? I can't describe any of the taste in it. It tastes of lager. It tastes of lager. That's it. It tastes of muck lager. Right. Kind of slight grapefruit notes there, and a slight processed bread crust. And that's it. And it's kind of smooth on the throat. And when I say buy it and try it, fuck off. No way. Just that. It's 640 millilitres of something that I ain't going to be able to drink 200 of it. So I ain't going to drink the rest of that. That's going down the sink. Cheers.